What's up? I'm Will, and welcome to my fourth annual Scooter Check, the world's first Scooter Check in 4K! Drop the bass! No. Right, let's get on with it. Let's start with the bar ends. Now, the main thing people like about these is the way you can screw them into your bars using an Allen key, so they lock in. But the main thing I like about them is the way they're sort of completely indestructible.
Right, so I've got some high explosives hooked up to my brother's scooter, which has the bar ends attached to it. Let's blow this thing up. Awesome. Oh my word, it completely went! Oh, and the bar ends are unscathed!
Hello? Hello? Ah. Hello.
And what did the geniuses who created these bar ends choose to call them? Why? Odyssey par ends bar ends. What? Next, I've got my white lizard skin chargers. They are super comfy and are the best grips in the world. Now, that's just my personal opinion, but if you disagree with it, you're wrong!
Raptor bars!
These 680 by 620 chromalloy steel bars weigh 1.8 kilograms, have zero back sweep, and have been specially designed for lanky freak shows. And on top of all that, these are the signature bars of the one and only scooter legend, everyone knows him, Remy Bouchard. Next, I've got my 2-bolt lucky clamp.
What is this?
No! I didn't want you to find out this way.
How could you?
It wasn't me.
Who was it then?
It was the man at the shop. He said you weren't strong enough to hold these bars. So I knew if I used you, you'd regret it. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but soon. And for the rest of your life.
But what about us?
We'll always have Horfield. This is my blue Nico headset, which is the only remaining part still in use from my old scooter. It still spins just as well as it did in 2012. Next I've got my Blazer Pro Fork. It fits 100mm and 110mm wheels.
What is this? I can't believe you replaced me!
Who cares? That was 2 years ago. This is my front wheel. It's a, what is it? Oh, yeah. It's a 5-spoked, 100mm, 88 APU, reinforced performance urethane, aeroplane-grade aluminium, alloy-welded, plated with anodized steel, laser-etched, grade-free, level 5, buff core, integrated, flintegrated, built-in tension bracket, torsion-mounted, scalable surface. I don't know what I'm saying, and you're not listening! UK-made default Razor Ultra Pro Green Edition wheel! Now, a couple people have asked me if this is custom grip tape, and it actually isn't. What I did was I bought some see-through grip tape, and then printed out the words mint orange, stuck them on my deck, and then stuck the see-through grip tape over the top. I'm really pleased with the end result, and somehow it's managed to stay grippy and clean, even after a year or so. This is my Vertex Whisper Brake. It is very tough, and the type of brake you can really rely on to stop your scooter in a crucial situation. Such as, Game of Pig, or, the impending zombie apocalypse. Lastly, we have my back wheel, which has clearly taken quite the beating. I'd say it still has, a good month or so left in it. But I still need your help to decide what pair of wheels I should get when this one does finally implode. Now, I know everyone's gonna say,
"Shut up and get some pros, you old man!"
But these are all wheels that I've been wanting to try out for ages. So, as you can see, each wheel has a number on it. I've posted 4 comments below, each with the wheel name and number. All you have to do is like the wheel that you want me to try out. The voting will finish when my back wheel finally breaks, which, as you can see, is probably not going to be too long. So get voting, chumps! So that's pretty much it. I think there's only one thing left to discuss. The hat. No, actually, you know what? Let's not discuss the hat, okay? No one comment about it, okay? No one tell me what you think. You know, in fact, it's gone, okay? The hat's gone, alright? Okay, never mind. Bye! I did it. I made the scooter check. I did it!